Well, hey kids, wherever you're at, stand on up with us and let's sing together. Here we go. Come on and sing with us. We're gonna sing about the power of God, about His goodness and His holiness and His love for us. Here we go. Who breaks the power of sin and darkness? Whose love is mighty and so much stronger? The King of glory, the King above all kings. Who shakes the whole earth? Who shakes the whole earth with holy thunder? Who leaves us breathless in awe and wonder? The King of glory, the King above all kings. Oh, this is amazing grace. This is unfailing love, that You would take my place, that You would bear my cross. Jesus, You would lay down Your life, that I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that You've done for me. Who brings our chaos back into order? Who makes the orphan a son and daughter? The King of glory, the King of glory. Who rules the nations with truth and justice? Shines like the sun in all of its brilliance. The King of glory, the King above all kings. Here we go. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love, that You would take my place, that You would bear my cross. Oh, You would lay down Your life, that I would be set free.
Hi, ABC kids and families. I'm Tony, and I'm going to read for you a really special book. It's called The Garden, The Curtain, and The Cross. A very long time ago, right here in this world, there was a garden. In the garden, everything was wonderful. The world was full of laughing and playing and smiling and fun. There was nothing bad ever. There was no one sad, ever. And best of all, God was there.
Hello, Adam. Hello, Eve.
He made it all. He was in charge of it all. He loved it all. People could see God and speak to God and just enjoy being with God.
Eve, God's here. He wants to walk with us again. How cool is that?
Yay, I bet it's going to be even more amazing than it was yesterday.
It was wonderful to live with God. But then, one day, the people did a terrible thing. They decided they didn't want to do what God said. They decided they wanted a world without God in charge. God calls this sin. Sin spoils things. So sin has no place in God's wonderful garden. God said to the people, "You can't live with me in my garden anymore." And he sent them outside. To show the people they had to stay outside, God put some warrior angels in front of the garden. The angels were like a big keep out sign. Now, things were sometimes bad, and people were sometimes sad. But people still kept sinning because they didn't want God to be in charge. So, no one could come into God's wonderful place. God said, "Because of your sin, you can't come in." God wanted people to remember, it is wonderful to live with Him, but because of your sin, you can't come in. So, He told the people to build a special building called His temple, where He would live. In the middle of the temple was the most wonderful place in the world, the place where God was, with nothing bad and nothing sad. It was very exciting. But then God told people to put a big curtain around this wonderful place. The curtain had pictures of warrior angels on it. It was a big keep out sign. For hundreds of years, the temple curtain reminded people that God said, "It is wonderful to live with Him, but because of your sin, you can't come in." Babies became grown-ups and had babies. And those babies became grown-ups and had babies. And those babies became grown-ups and had babies. Hundreds of summers and winters went by. And the keep-out curtain stayed in the temple. Then, one day, God the Son came to live in this world as a person. He was called Jesus. Jesus always did what God said. Jesus never sinned. And Jesus visited the temple where the keep-out curtain hung. Jesus knew that things were sometimes bad and sometimes sad. Jesus said that God had sent him to open the way back to God's wonderful place, where there would be nothing bad and no one sad. But people still didn't want to let God be in charge. So they decided to put Jesus on a cross to die. It was the most bad thing that had ever happened. It was the most sad day of all time. But Jesus had a plan. He had always planned to die on a cross. What a strange plan. Why would God's Son plan to die? On the cross, Jesus took our sin. All the bad things we do and all the sad things they cause, Jesus took them all from us. And when He did, something amazing, astonishing, astounding happened. The curtain tore. God had ripped up the keep out sign. God's wonderful place is open again. Because Jesus died, we can go in. After Jesus died, His friends put Him in a tomb. They were very sad. For 2 days, nothing happened. Then, the next morning, Jesus' friends went to see his body in the tomb.
And it wasn't there! He's not here!
A little later on, Jesus' friends were all together, and suddenly, Jesus was there, alive! Suddenly, his friends weren't sad. Now they were so, so happy. God had brought Jesus back to life so that he could live in God's wonderful place forever. And Jesus has sent everyone an invitation to come and live with him there too. He tells us, God says it is wonderful to live with him. Because of your sin, you can't come in. But I died on the cross to take your sin, so all my friends can now come in. We can live with God forever. There will be nothing bad and no one sad.
Come on in, friends!
We will see God and speak to God and just enjoy being with God, just as he planned. It will be wonderful to live with him. And it's all because of Jesus. We will say every day, thank you, King Jesus, you're amazing. You can start saying that today. And that, my friends, is the book, the garden, the curtain, and the cross.
What an incredible story. Tony, thank you so much for sharing that with us. Now kids, we have one more activity for you to participate in. If you go and have your parents help you, go to artforkidshub.com. And the people at artforkidshub.com have produced a drawing tutorial to help you draw an empty tomb. So go over there, draw that, and then you're gonna take a picture of that and send it into the church. So go to artforkidshub.com, learn how to draw an empty tomb, and have your parents take a picture of your drawing and send that to mail@abcchurch.org. Again, that's mail@abcchurch.org. And you might see that in a special way this Sunday morning for our Easter service. Now, we do have Easter service this Sunday at 10 o'clock a.m. And before that, at 9:30, we're gonna be back here doing some special things just for you kids. We're gonna have another message, we're gonna have some worship songs, and some more interactive fun for you to participate in. So again, that's this Sunday, 10 a.m., but kids, you be back here at 9:30 a.m., and we'll do some more special stuff. We will see you guys on Sunday morning.